Welcome back to the 2005 Juno Awards. Our next presenter and I have a very special bond. You see, she once wrote a beautiful song entitled Basement Apartment, and I am this close to moving out of one. Please welcome the very talented Sarah Harmer.
When I was 16, I spent a summer in bars across small town Ontario watching one of the best bands in the world. The Tragically Hip had the magic then and they have it now. I am hugely honored to help celebrate their incredible musical alchemy and give thanks and praise on behalf of the artistic community. Not only are they an undeniable musical force, they are also great supporters of the many bands that they've hosted on endless cross-continent tours. The Tragically Hip have become true Canadian icons, and our hats are off to them for their art and their heart.
Oh, hi there. My congratulations to the Tragically Hip on their induction into the Canadian Music Hall of Fame. Even someone as tragically unhip as me understands the enduring, the universal appeal of the music, the lyrics, and Bobby Baker's spectacular hairdo.
Tragically Hip, five close friends from Kingston, have established themselves as one of the most treasured and talented musical acts in Canada.
You are ahead by a century. You are ahead by a century. You are ahead by a century.
They've been honored with a gleaming star on Canada's Walk of Fame, a command performance for the Queen.
Thank you very much.
And now, a place in the Canadian Music Hall of Fame.
Gord.
Gord is hot.
If I wasn't married to her, I'd be married to Gord.
Just Langlois, though, man, that guy's the essence of cool.
Not to mention, I heard Johnny Faye is still the only single hit member ladies. How can you miss out on that?
The bass riff and Twist My Arm. Me and my buddies just used to rock out on that.
The new songs are wonderful. The old songs kick ass. You guys are tighter than ever. I love it.
Find somewhere to go. Go somewhere.
Well, when you hear the Hip, you hear Canada. They're the chroniclers of our time.
You know, Gord's lyrics are just so rich and so elusive and so full of possible interpretation and meaning, as any great poetry is.
Combine that with a really great, chunky style of rock and roll.
Their sound is very pure and straightforward. There's nothing that's kind of artificial about it. It's very natural.
They're just a real band. They've stuck it out and made good records and wrote good songs.
We really hope that this is only the midpoint award in your career and that you're going to keep making great music, the kind of music that's inspired us all.
And I ask you, is there anything more Canadian than a band that has not one, but two guys named Gord?
When you're 95, I want to see you on stage.
We're the greatest Canadian band ever.
We love you! Oh my God! We just love you! We are Hip fans!
Find somewhere to go. Go somewhere. Find somewhere.
Here in Kingston, you've made our city so proud.
They've helped me out a lot with my foundation. All the charity work they do is something not a lot of people know about.
As well as making fine music, you've been great friends of the environment. Good on you, mates.
They're honest, good-working men, fantastic golfers, good hockey players.
You've always given us the groove. You've always given us so much more. You've always given us something to think about.
There's been no band like them in the history of Canadian music. There's their dedicated fan base, their poetic, truly Canadian lyrics are an inspiration to all of us in the music community. We love the Hip, and we see them as kind of our older stoner brothers.
For the last 20 years, you've represented our country with class and dignity. Congratulations, well deserved.
We love you guys very, very much.
Especially you, Paul. You know what I mean?
Stands abused and oppressed by just one man. For you, move the UN headquarters to Halifax. All right, we'll take care of it from there. All right, give me a blue helmet. Come on, come on, come on.
He said, "I'm
the door. You two running in high heels, I've seen you before.
Alan Doyle and the award for Rap Recording of the Year.